Hello everyone, welcome to Paper Craft Mix. It's me, Brigitte, and you are watching this week's Craft Mix video. I don't have a lot to show you. I didn't buy a lot because I'm very busy this week with work. We have to go to a fair, I don't know if that's the right word, to a congress with work. And this Saturday, my crafty sissies, my YouTube friends here from the Netherlands, come over to my house to craft together, to eat together. It's been a long time since we've seen each other as a whole group, so I can't wait for that. But of course, that also takes some preparations. So I do not have a lot of time to craft this week, but I did buy a few things. What you are looking at right now are my pen pastels. These pen pastels, I think a lot of you also have in your stash. I have them for years and they were collecting dust for years. But last week I went to the craft store where I go to because I wanted to buy this jar of Viva Ice Crystal. I'm going to show it to you. I don't know if you know this from Viva, but it's beautiful ice crystals that are perfect to use on a card or on a layout or something for Christmas or for winter. I love it. So I went over there for this jar, and when I was there, they were making takes with pen pastel, and I knew I had these in my stash and I didn't touch them for quite some years. So I thought, let's take a look, and I sat down to the table of Joyce. Also Dini Sprakel was giving the make and take there, but I went to the table of Joyce and she learned us a technique with the pen pastels. I will put them back. And what she learned us was to use the pen pastels with embossed paper. But the paper was not embossed with an embossing folder like I used to do with my pen pastels. I also use them together with VersaMark ink, with stamps and with stencils. But she showed us that you can also emboss, and that really was new to me. Maybe I have been lying under a stone or something, but it was new for me. You can emboss with this kind of stencils. And of course, it was quite the search to find the perfect sandwich for my die cutting machine. I have a Joycraft Truvaille Dutch machine, but I did find it. And that's why I also bought this stencil there. I really love it. It's called the Dutch Mask Art Pepita. And I have a jacket in this Pepita pattern. I love it. So that's why I took this home, and that was the only things I bought at the store. But I will show you the card I made during the make and take. It was this one. She used a different stencil. It's a stencil with writing, but I used it in the wrong way. And yeah, we just did the pen pastel with our sponges over the background. And afterwards, I also stenciled with the pen pastels. And for the rest, it's just stamping, and also stamping the stars and the sentiment on a different paper and cutting them out. And I used a marker. So really simple card. I just did it really quickly, within 20 minutes, I think. But I really, really wanted to play with the pen pastels again after I've done this card. It was so inspiring. And it's so nice to use all things from your stash again. You know, I'm doing that all year with my stash dive challenge. And I didn't think for those videos about my pen pastels. And now I did. So really happy with that. And I can show you one little sneak peek that I made using the embossing or the stencil I just showed you. This will be a part of the project, one of the projects for the challenge I'm going to do in December for the 24 days. And look, I embossed the paper with that stencil, as you can see, cut it out with an old Marianne Design tag die, and I used the pen pastels in the background. I let them mix together or blend in together. And what I learned afterwards, I did look at a video from Dini Sprakel afterwards in the weekend, that there's also a colorless pen pastel. That was also new for me. A colorless pen pastel that you can use before you are going to use the other colors. And that will make the pen pastels blend better together. That was new for me. And there's also a pearlescent one, a colorless, that you can put over it and it gives you a shine. So I really need to go hunt for that, for those two as well, because that will look marvelous on your project. And I also need a fixative, because I don't have a fixative. And for this, I don't think it's a problem. But if you have big cards, then I do think you need to fix the pen pastels, because they are really soft. So yeah, that's three other things to go on my wish list. And for the rest, I decorated it with paper and stickers from a doodlebug collection that I have. It's an older one in my stash. And I stamped. So yeah, that was my play with the pen pastels this week. For the rest, the only thing I bought in the store was this cute duct tape. I love it and I can use it for my happy mail or something, or when I am going to send out a card. This is so much nicer than the plain clear one or black or white duct tape. So yeah, that's this one. And I have bought a de-stash from Happy Eveness on Instagram, Yvette. And she de-stashed, yes, she de-stashed Simple Stories, Let's Get Crafty. And you all know I have that collection in digital and on paper a little bit, because I did do the journal for my friend Nadezhda with that collection. And Yvette de-stashed a lot of it, and also a few items that I did not own. So I was really happy. I was the first one to connect with her. Look, she had two packs, big packs of die cuts. I love it. Of course, I have the collection digital. I can print it out, but then I need to fussy cut it myself by hand, because I don't have an electronic cutting machine that cuts around the images. And this is a lot of it. And I'm really happy with it, because I have a project in mind for Christmas for my mother. And as you know, my mother crafts as well. And yeah, I am thinking about a project for her, and the Let's Get Crafty will be perfect for it. She also had the puffy stickers, and look, there's only one gone, so almost a complete pack. I love these ones to use on embellishments because of the small size. And the colors and the images are so cute from this collection. It's yeah, I understand that it's such a popular collection everywhere. She also had a lot of the puffy stickers, the sentiment stickers. I didn't have any of those, so really nice to have some of them now. And she also had a whole lot of the chipboard still left. And in both of the packs, my favorite one is still in. So I love that so much. So cute. And for the rest, she had a little bit of paper left. Not so much. A few pages. And another paper pads and a whole lot of scraps, as you can see. She included just everything that she had. And those little scraps can be used as well on embellishments or on cards. So yeah, that was all that I have for you today. I hope you will be back for my next video. That will be the unboxing of my kit that I received from my friend Nadezhda. She invited me to design for her this month again for her kits from Marchena Design. And I already filmed, videoed the kit, but I still have to edit this. We have a little bit of a problem with the Wi-Fi the last week. It's really unstable, and tomorrow they will come to fix it, hopefully. So yeah, you have to wait for that. But I hope you will be back to check out that beautiful kit, because she really, really challenged me with the things that she sent to me. They are so diverse. It really is a challenge, but if you want to see that, then you have to be back. So thank you for watching, and I hope you have a great rest of the day. Bye for now.